Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how you can save any video that you can find online with OBS Studio. Okay, so I have a video that I get a lot of questions about, and people say it doesn't work on saving Vimeo videos. And that involves going to the source code and finding the MP4 file, and then you can right click and save that file as. And due to privacy settings, you can, for some reason, you can't do that on every single video. So I wanted to show you how you can do that on every video. I would also, though, like to caution that I don't condone you stealing anyone's work. I think that if you're using it for personal use, that's fine. Like if you're saving a clip for something, or you bought a course and you want it offline, so you want to save some videos, there's nothing wrong with that. But if you're using someone's work to share it with other people and you don't have permission to do that, either commercially or non-commercially, I would say don't do that. And ask them for permission before you do that. So if there's a private video, there might be a reason why, and you should ask the author why. But that's just, you know, my two cents about that, because I think creators put a lot of time into what they do, and to steal their work without credit and give other people their work for free is unfair. As a creative myself. So just wanted to say that before I show you this video. But you can see here, I have this Casey Neistat video up here, and I might, let's say for this instance, I want to make a clip of, you know, a few seconds of it. Now with YouTube, you can do that really easily. There are some other things, like people were having problems with Vimeo because of the privacy settings. There's also another, like if it's a flash video that's playing, it might be hard to grab that video by going through the source code, or you can download the flash file, but then you don't have flash. So how do you watch the video? So this will show you how you can record anything that you're seeing on your screen. Including videos. So right now I'm recording this screen here, and I have, you can see here, this would normally say start recording, but because I'm recording, it says stop recording. And I have my microphone going here, and then there's desktop audio that is currently turned off. You can turn that on, and you would want to turn that on if you were recording a video. So I'm going to just temporarily turn that on so that we can capture this clip. Hit the plus sign down here. And there's going to be a link to OBS in the comments, so if you want to go download that, it's free. And if you're doing streaming, you can use it as well. I use it to record all my videos. You can either choose display capture or window capture for this. So display is your entire monitor. Window is like, I could just select this window. A lot of times I feel like the window doesn't work, or the window that I want doesn't come up. So I usually pick display. So I'm gonna do that, display capture 6. I'm choosing, that's my dual monitor right there. So I'm gonna just select this. And I'm just making a copy of this so I don't ruin everything. And you can see I have some little circles here. I can drag those, and it'll let me scale. You can also, there's a way to, or there used to be a way to crop in here, but it doesn't seem like that's an option anymore. So let me just scale this. There you go, it's close enough. What I'm going to do, and you're going to lose me on here as I do this, so I'm going to describe what I'm doing. I'm going to right-click on Display Capture 6, go to Filters, hit the plus sign, and add Crop/Pan. Now in here, I have some options where I can change these numbers, and you'll see as I do it that the screen starts to shrink. So I'm just going to start typing in numbers. So left looks like it's not very much. So 50, 60. Now the thing to be aware of when you do this is that if you're doing more than one video, you want to make sure it's positioned in the same way. so that you don't have to come in here every time. So what I'm doing here is just dragging that up. The left side is fine, and I'm not scrolled anywhere here. If there was like a left-right scrolling, I would want to make sure that I was like all the way to the left so that that was consistent. And then for this, I'm just going to make sure that I'm scrolled all the way to the top. And this looks pretty good. So now I'm going to crop to this. So if I ever want to use this again, or I could even do the full screen, that's probably what I would recommend, is just do your full screen. If you're doing multiple of these, so that you know, just click this maximize button. But so you would know exactly that you're set up to record that over and over and over again. But for this, I'm trying to show you how to do this, so it's a little tough to show both. So I'm just gonna look at this top. Let's say 100. That's not enough. 300. 250. 225, 210, 200. Okay, now I'm just gonna up this until I don't see any. That looks good. Right, let's say there's a whole lot of right. 500, 1,000, 1,100, 1,000. 1,000, let's say 50, 75. Now I'm just gonna hit this little up arrow till we get close. Okay, now bottom, let's say 200. Left, I'm just gonna go back a little bit until I see white and then select one more. Okay, there we go. Bottom, let's say 600. Way too much. 500, 300, 400. That looks good. I want to make sure that the top is one more. There we go. Okay, so you can see I'm honing on the crop here, and then I'm going to close this. You can't see what I'm doing anymore, but I'm going to scale this so that it is the full screen. It's a little pixelated. Down here, if there's an option, so currently it's at auto 720. If you're saving a video, you want to make sure it's the best quality that you can do. So I can save this video here. Just trying to position it so it's centered. There you go. And then when I hit record,
by far the worst idea.
So I could save just a little tiny clip of that video, or save the whole thing. But the thing that you need to just be careful of is that I can record this whole video, but what I want to do, I want to be there to make sure that I'm stopping the recording so that it's not saving like a huge file when I'm finished. Because if you just let it go, it's just going to keep recording and the file is going to be massive. So I guess along with that, you want to make sure you have enough disk space. Like if you have 500 or a gigabyte of space left, you probably want to clear some space before you do that. Now I'm back here and I just want to show you one more thing. I just hit settings down here. If you go to, output, that's going to give you the settings for where everything is going. Is it output? Yeah, okay. So I'm not sure why this isn't showing. It's probably because I'm recording right now. But if you go to output under recording, you can choose the path. I save all mine to a separate drive, and it's called RAW, basically like the RAW recording. And then the recording format you can change. I like MP4 because it saves, I don't know, maybe I just grew up listening to MP3s, so MP4 is cool. And then I split my audio into two separate tracks. So if I do use the desktop audio, it's separate from the microphone audio. So that makes it easy in editing if I want to get something out or put something in. But yeah, so that's what you would do. You'd go to this recording path location and retrieve your file, and then you would have it. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.